Good afternoon. Welcome back to TSC TV. I've had two or three phone calls lately from people saying, is a cybercide a good investment? Over the last few years, there has been a certain decline in the sale of cybersides. People have tended to go more for over and unders. But in the last couple of years, there's been a move back to people shooting game with cybersides. I've had two or three phone calls lately from people saying, is a cyberside a good investment? If you were going to buy a cyberside, what would you buy? I've got a budget between £1,000 and £2,000. I want to go and shoot four or five times a year, game shooting. The rest of the time I'm going to shoot plays with my over and under. So what would you recommend? In fact, only yesterday I had a chap rang me and said, of the three guns, which one would you buy? And I said, the one that fits you the best and the one that you're happiest with. Basically, we've got three, between £1,000 and £2,000, I've picked out three guns that I think are absolutely ideal for that price bracket. But they vary a great deal. I've got an English box shot by Robin and Shot. I've got an AYA number 2 side lock by AYA, and I've got a Fausti cyber side by Fausti. They are very, very different guns. If you want a gun that is nice and light, then something like a Webby 700 would be ideal. They actually did three different guns in that 700 range. They did the 700, they did the 702, which for some unknown reason was the middle one, and the 701, which was the best one. Over Webley's lifetime, they made apparently about 80,000 box shops. So it's a tried and tested gun. So the Webley 700 that I've got here is nice light little gun, 28 inch barrels, nice long stock, got bits of visual colour hardening, but a nice light game gun. 2.5 inch chambers, because a gun like this you don't want to put cannon shells through it. Even if it's got 2.75 inch chambers, I always say shoot nice light 2.5 inch game cartridges, the gun will then shoot nicely. So that's a basic English box shot. Very good value for money at the moment. The next one is Spanish. That's an AYA number 2. Slightly heavier than the English gun, 2.75 inch chambers, and this one is absolutely like brand new. That gun new would cost you £8,000. So they're fantastic value for money because at the moment the price of AYA, particularly number 2s and number 1s, hasn't caught up with the new price. Heavier than the English gun, a little bit more height in the comb as well. English guns look quite a lot of drop on them. Spanish guns, AYA particularly, a little bit more height in the comb, which makes them, from my view, easier to shoot. Then if you go from there, you go for a Fausti. Now that's an Italian cyberside. Italian cybersides feel very, very different to Spanish and English cybersides. Italian cybersides, because the Italians don't really shoot much driven game the way we do, their guns tend to be a little bit heavier and chunkier. People who shoot with over and unders quite like them. This one is what they call a Fausti class. it's unusual in the fact that it's three places. Most of their bookshops in this model were bookshops, but this one's been three places. It was custom made 8 or 10 years ago, and it's virtually only shot from new. The person we bought it from told us that he'd only shot 100 cartridges through it in 10 years. So, absolutely brand new. Again, just under £2,000. So, if you're thinking about buying a Cyberslide, either as an investment or to shoot game with, look at what is available, because when you go from the English bookshop to the Italian bookshop, they are chalk and cheese. The AYA comes between the two. AYA, as always say, they're built in the English tradition, and they are. They're very much like an English stone to pick up a mount, fractionally heavier. Whereas Italian Cyberslides tend to be a little bit heavier. Also, this Fausti is unusual because Fausti didn't really import double trigger guns into the UK, but this one is a double trigger. So, as far as I can find out, that was a special order. So you're talking about £1,000, £1,500, £2,000. So if you want a gun to go out game shooting, and you don't want to spend a fortune on it, but want to be traditional, one of those would suit the bill. But because they are so very different, you need to go somewhere where they can look at all the three different types of cyberside available and decide what suits you. If you have any questions about this type of gun, please give me a ring, like and subscribe, and the next film that I do will roll on from this again about game guns, because game guns this time of year, everybody's talking about, thinking about going to the game season, they're talking about maybe treating themselves to a new game gun. So, as I said before, like and subscribe, we'll see you in the near future.